Hey, Arthur. Good to see you.
Why? You want rescuing again, do you?
No. I got a plan to make it up to you.
A plan like the Blackwater ferry job, or like you going off scouting and ending up in jail?
Dutch said you was a big shadow cast by a tiny tree.
I don't even know what that means.
I thought you was a tough boy. Not one of those gentlemen trying to protect his riding clothes.
Well, I just know whenever things get real, you turn yellow, lose your head.
Yellow?
Sure seems that way.
So I guess you won't be riding with me to rob the banking coach comes about this time in the Strawberry. I heard one of the O'Driscoll boys yapping about it while I was inside.
You and me? Do a robbery?
That's what I said, didn't I?
After you.
Come on. I know an overlook where we can watch for them coming in.
What are you doing anyway, camping out here like some crazy hermit?
Can't exactly stay in town now, can I? Like I told you, I ain't going back to Dutch without a peace offering.
So what's the deal with this coach?
What do you mean? Comes through about this time every day, like I said, the end.
I mean, how many men, guns, riders?
Nothing serious. It'll be fine.
I heard the bank's been hiring every trigger man they can get of late. The meaner, the better.
You worry too much.
Forgive me if I ain't wholly faithful in something an old O'Driscoll told you when you was half drunk in a jail cell.
He kept yapping about it, saying now they've been hitting it on the regular. That's a good lead in my book.
Damn, O'Driscolls are everywhere now.
Bastards got a hold of most of Big Valley. Heard they took over some big ranch north of here.
How the hell you and Lenny end up down here, anyway?
Oh, you know how it is? A few loose ends. Drink here, drink there.
What loose ends?
Nothing that needs to concern you. I always pay my share.
It concerns me when you put us in danger and we don't realize till it's too late. Like that move you pulled in Strawberry. Making me kill half the town just for your precious guns.
Precious they are. You need to roll a little looser, Morgan.
Looser? I seen you come full undone more than once now, and you only been running with us a few months.
Are we gonna rob this coach or bicker about it? What's done is done.
Guess we're robbing it.
Then let's do it. Up on this ridge. Easy. They should be here in a little bit. Hold tight.
Which way will they be coming in?
Should be from over there. We need to hit them fast before they get into town.
Just don't lose your head this time.
Of course, tough guy. They should be here any minute. Look, there they are. Right on time. Get covered up. Come on! Ride! Yeah!
Yeah! keep your face covered now.
It's just you and me, sweetheart.
I'll give it to them. They put up half a fight, at least. Yeah! Baylock! Come on, boy! Here. Fine new rifle, too. Here you go, Arthur. From me to you. That's more your style than mine.
You've got a point.
Let's strip his coats, then. He clearly ain't going nowhere now. You know, we should really pick up a lockbreaker one of these days. Save ourselves some bullets.
Yeah, because saving bullets is such a concern of yours.
Get out of here.
take what we can and get the hell out of here. That lock should shoot off easy enough. I'll give you the honors, on account of, well, this little mess. That should do it.
Come on, let's see if all this was worth it.
All I see is you, me, a river full of dead O'Driscolls, and a lockbox. I'd say we're golden here, Morgan. Look at that.
Hey.
What's the cut here?
It's good. Just make sure the gang gets its piece.
Yeah, yeah. Like I said, big shadow, tiny tree.
And like I said, that still don't mean nothing. Get out of here. Go see Dutch. Make sure you ain't followed.
I know, boss. I know. It's been fun!
Let's go, boy.
How you doing?
So, Mr. Morgan, whatever did happen with that Mary Gill?
It all came to nothing, Miss Grimshaw.
That's for the best.
Sure, of course.
I never did like you very much.
You busy, Arthur?
Good morning, Arthur.
You good, Charles?
Yeah. Already wishing we'd left Sean hanging from that tree.
Oh, I know what you mean. Javier?
I heard about a house. Could be interesting.
What kind of a house?
I don't know. A couple fellas I heard in town, they said it was really freakish. A family local boogeymen, I guess. But they're crooked in every way.
So?
It's up north, on the other side of the river from Valentine. Best way there is through Cumberland Falls, though. You know it?
Sure, more or less.
Pretty close now. Let's stop and go. On foot from here. Just up the hill this way. Follow me. There's a spot up ahead where we should be able to get a good look at the place. I want to make sure we don't run into any surprises.
Sure.
Apparently, this family's been isolated for so long, they started talking in their own weird dialect. They really don't like outsiders, especially on their turf.
Well, you just keep selling me on this job, don't you? Pretty big barn in the back. It's not a bad place to start looking. There must be a lot of people living here. A large house.
Stash could be in any one of them buildings, and who knows how many people are in there. I ain't sure about this.
Boy, I think we need to draw them out somehow. I got an idea. Follow me.
All these trees. I can't get a proper look at the place.
Well, hopefully it'll make it harder for them to spot us, too.
Coast seems clear so far.
Yeah, so far.
Hey, keep it down. I hear voices. Come on, let's hide behind this shed. See if we can hear what they're saying. Just stay quiet.
This time one's mouth.
Creepers, Finn. Don't score notions in the dippy Plymouth's head.
Where you been now, Newt? Don't be boiling now, Pappy. I's gone but 10 minutes I was.
You can lollygag on an hour day long, cause Edie takes patrol now, don't you?
What? Yo, Edie, get all the jam!
You shut your gupper, or I'll flag her your felt, I will. Your niece will pull it up, boy. Up. Go guard the shed.
Go!
You understand what they're saying?
Not much of it. What are we doing, Javier?
Okay. Take cover by the rock over there. I'll create a little distraction, and then you jump them, okay?
What kind of distraction?
You'll see.
Be quiet.
Mm-hmm. the hickory happen here? We got to put this out, don't you? Oh.
Hey! I keep...
Hellfire!
Now, Arthur!
Has to be under here. There's no place else I could store it. Hey, Arthur. Give me a hand here. I told you it was worth the trouble, didn't I?
Here, you take this. Let's split up. I'll meet you back at camp.
Sounds good.
Easy there. There's a girl.
Thank you.
girl. Stay. Hey, girl. You're okay. It's okay. Easy now. Stay. Take it easy. All right, girl. Hey, you're okay, girl. Come on, girl. Yeah.
there. That horse doing all right? If you want me to keep that overnight, there's room in the stable.
Well, it happened before.
If you ain't got papers, I can't give you much. I've been burned before. Good-looking horse there. I'm happy to stable that for you. Best to have a good saddle that'll hold up. That's a nice addition on a saddle. Always good to have one of those. It's all yours. I got one of them myself. Yeah, grooming a horse sure makes it a beaut. A few careful trims and this horse will look just fine. Some grooming goes a long way. Looks nice. Yep.
Careful!